Hello everyone, today we'll have a look at gender, a grammatical category that Slovene has and English doesn't. In Slovene, nouns are divided into three classes. We call these three classes gender. There's some overlap between grammatical gender and biological sex, but it's mostly arbitrary. More on this later. There's the masculine, the feminine, and neuter. This is different from English, where we treat all nouns as the same in this regard. Why is it important that there are three classes of nouns? Because words such as adjectives and pronouns change their form according to, among other things, the gender of the noun. So, if you want to use the correct form of an adjective, you have to know the gender. For example, there's no single word for good in Slovene. The good in good breakfast isn't the same as the good in good lunch, and it isn't the same as the good in good dinner either. The Slovene word for breakfast is masculine, lunch is neuter, and dinner is feminine. An adjective has to agree with a noun in gender. So, for breakfast you have to choose the masculine form of good, for lunch the neuter, and for dinner the feminine. Okay, so how do we know the gender of the noun in order to use the correct form of an adjective or pronoun? Keep in mind there are always exceptions, but in general, follow these rules. If a noun ends in a consonant, it's masculine. If it ends in A, it's feminine. And if it ends in E or O, it's neuter. If a noun ends in a consonant, presume it's masculine. The words for tea, hill, and hotel are, for example, masculine. Chai, hrib, and hotel all end in a consonant. Since we are talking about a language, there will always be exceptions to the rule. Even though noč, stvar, and luč all end in a consonant, they're all feminine. Don't worry about this for now, just know that there are exceptions. If a noun ends in the letter A, then presume it's feminine. Coffee, tie, and table are examples of feminine nouns in Slovene. Kava, kravata, and miza end in an A. The words for colleague and accountant, on the other hand, are both masculine, even though they end in A, and Alyosha is a male given name. And if a noun ends in the letter E or O, presume it's neuter. Examples are words like city, window, and sea, or mesto, okno, and morje. Exceptions are, for example, father, car, and cinema, or oče, auto, and kino. Now I know it looks like there are a lot of exceptions, but that's just because we intentionally included three exceptions per three normal examples. You really don't have to worry about them. Languages are full of exceptions, and at the beginning it's best to just take things one step at a time. Okay, let's have a look now at how to use an adjective with a noun. When talking about the basic form of an adjective in Slovene, we always have the masculine in mind. In dictionaries, the masculine is listed first and is followed by the feminine and neuter. We form the feminine by adding an A to the masculine, and we form the neuter by adding an O to the basic masculine form. So let's take an adjective like big, for example, which is velik in Slovene. As we said, to get the feminine form we add an A, so we get velika, and for the neuter form we add an O, veliko. The adjective big in Slovene is then velik, velika, veliko. Let's use it to form noun phrases. The word for computer is masculine, so we get velik računalnik. Tie is feminine, so it's velika kravata. And city is neuter, so the correct form is veliko mesto. Notice that the stress shifts from the first syllable in velik to the second syllable in velika and veliko. Just notice that it happens and don't worry about it. I do suggest, however, that you always repeat things verbally, even if you're just practicing by writing or memorizing new vocabulary. That's where the diacritics come in handy. If you don't know what I mean by diacritics, watch the lesson on the alphabet. We follow the same rule with the adjective expensive or drag. Draga is feminine and drago is neuter. An expensive hotel is drag hotel. An expensive table is draga miza. And an expensive window is drago okno. Okay, now for an exception that's very common and you should know about. If the last syllable of the adjective has an E, and if the E is pronounced as a schwa, so e, then the letter E itself disappears in the feminine and neuter form of the adjective. So, in the case of good or dober, it's not dober, dobera, dobero, but dober, dobra, dobro. There are many adjectives like this, and you'll get to know them with time. Let's list a few common ones. Lačen, lačna, lačno. Žejen, žejna, žejno. Prijazen, prijazna, prijazno. Nesramen, nesramna, nesramno. Hiter, hitra, hitro. Počasen, počasna, počasno. Pameten, pametna, pametno. Neumen, neumna, neumno. Let's now use dober to do a couple of examples with the nouns from before that were exceptions. I mean the ones that didn't have the usual endings. So, if we go by the endings, it should be dobro oče, since dobro is the neuter form of the adjective and oče ends with an e, which suggests it's neuter. But since we know the word father is an exception in Slovene and is masculine, we use the masculine form. So, dober, dober oče. It's the same with car or auto. It looks like it should be dobro auto, but we know auto is masculine, and so we go for the masculine adjective, dobar auto. Same with thing or stvar. It ends in a consonant, so we should generally assume it's masculine. It's an exception though, and is actually feminine, and so we use the feminine form of the adjective dobra, dobra stvar. Let's have a look now at the similarities between gender and sex. First, let's make it clear that when using the word gender, we're talking about grammatical gender. Like we said, if the word is confusing, then just think of the word noun class instead. Think of the three noun classes that Slovene nouns fall into. However, like we said at the beginning of the lesson, there is some overlap between grammatical gender and biological sex. Basically, for humans and animals, the masculine and feminine often correlate with biological sex. So, with nationalities, professions, or other words that describe humans belonging to different groups and so on, Slovene has a masculine and feminine noun for both sexes. It's the same with animals, especially farm animals. Let's have a look at a couple of examples. So, the translation of the English noun American can be either Američan or Američanka. An Italian can be Italian or Italianka. A French person, Francoz or Francozinha. And the Chinese person, Kitaec or Kitajka. The same goes for professions, sports, hobbies, and so on. For example, a doctor is either zdravnik or zdravnica, a lawyer, odvetnik or odvetnica, a skier, smučar or smučarka, and for example, a beekeeper, čebelar or čebelarka. With animals, especially farm animals, it's the same as in English. The male and female are called by separate names. Rooster and hen are petelin and kokoš, bull and cow are bik and krava, ram and ewe are oven and ovca, and dog and bitch are pus and psica in Slovene. But don't use the word psica just like you wouldn't use bitch to refer to a female dog in English. The word psica has the same derogatory meaning as bitch, but it would stand out less when referring to a dog in Slovene. Still, don't use it. Just ask if it's a she. There are more animals like this that have separate names for the male and female, but we won't list more now. For all other animals, there is one word that refers to both sexes. For example, butterfly or metul is male, grasshopper or kobilica female, skunk or dihur male, and rat or podgana female. As you can see, the nouns that are feminine again end with a. However, if you knew that a rat is male, you'd still use the feminine form of the adjective since there is no masculine noun to describe male rats. If you wanted to point out that it's male, you'd use either samets or samica. Samets is a noun describing a male animal and samica a female animal. Keep in mind that today we were just dealing with gender. Number and case are two other categories that affect nouns and adjectives. All the simple noun phrases today were in the singular and the case was always the nominative, which is the basic or dictionary form of the noun. Try to get used to the fact that Slovene nouns fall into three groups. Practice by taking an adjective and then change it according to three nouns of different genders. You can find additional exercises at abcslovene.com. The link is in the description. Good luck, study hard, and aim for the stars.